Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Alice Esiola, and it's my first time recording a video for YouTube. And the reason I'm doing this is because I realized that learning to do things by video is quicker than surfing through thousands of internet web. There was a time I was looking to do some certain things on ImageJ, and I found some video clip that helped, and also some I found some written step-by-step guide that helped me to do some of my analysis on ImageJ. So today I'm recording a screen. I'll be making a screen recording to show you how to draw dotted line in ImageJ, and also how to draw a line graph. So if you want to quantify the fluorescence signal in a particular area of your cell, I'll show you how to do that as well. So let's get started. In order to do this, we need to record, we need to open our ImageJ software. If you are using Fiji, it's also okay. So you click on it, and there you have your ImageJ opened and ready for you to fire up your analysis. There are two ways you can open your image file. The first one is to go through file and use the open function. There you can open your image. So here I have confocal images that I captured, and I'll be opening two of them. So these images are Z-stack images. So it acquired that as XYZ image so that we can make a maximum projection or a 3D projection of the sample. So the sample I'm working with is a conidia of Magnaporte. Magnaporte oryza is a rice blast fungus. So here the green signal here is this green signal from the nucleus, which is present as a single nucleus within each cell compartment. So for us to be able to then work with these Z-stack images that we've acquired, we'll make a maximum projection of this image. And to do this, we go to Stacks, Z-Project. It will ask you if you would like to make a maximum projection on an average intensity. So for the purpose of this tutorial, we'll be working with maximum projection so that we can have a single image. If you observe, you will notice that my green signal from my GFP tagged protein is now showing as white. It's easy to convert this back to the green color. All we have to go through is to go to the LUT function, and we select a green option. So you see it changes back to the green. Also, the bright channel field has been changed to green. So we can resolve this by splitting the image. So we go to color, split channel. So here we have our bright field and our fluorescence field. For the bright channel field, we can change it black back to a gray color. And if you want them to be merged together without either of the channel affecting the color, what you have to do is to go to Image, Color, Merge Channels. So remember that our green channel is having the C is a first channel, so we don't have a red channel. So our green channel is the first channel, and our gray panel, which is the bright field image, is the second channel. It's important to click on keep source image. If not, it will make you merge channel and close the different channel. So with this, we're able to then have a single image that contains both channel without the color of the green channel merging with the like it was before. So here, if you just want to see your localization of your fluorescent signal also at the background of the bright field, you could either just save your sample directly like this. Oh, I forgot. Because you're working with confocal images, it is always important to set a scale bar. So because this image have not been cropped or anything, the image bar can be automatically dictated by ImageJ. That's one of the important functions. So I'll be using a 10 micro meter scale bar. In order to increase the width of this scale bar, because it looks too tiny, you can always increase the height. So let's try using 12. And Most people like to show the size of the font, but for myself, I usually just ignore that. So in order to ignore this, I hide the text. Therefore, you only have the scale bar, but you could also leave it so that you have it written and you don't have to, you won't forget what the scale bar was. And then you could save your sample as a JPEG. And once it's saved, it's ready to, you can use it for what you need your image for. Another important thing is that sometimes we might not be interested in using the bright field channel, and that's why I'll be showing you how to make the dotted line. For us to do this, we can use any of these shape drawing tools. If you use the square one, you will be having a square image or the oval shape. But for me, I prefer to use the freehand selection tool. There are two freehand selection tools, the one that allows you to use the coordinates while you're clicking, and also the other one that you just a single click and then you draw around your sample. So those are the two different ones, but you can see my hand was wobble. It looks wobble when I was drawing this, so I'm going to be using the other one so that it allowed me to draw a more better outline of my cell sample. So all you just have to do is continue clicking as you're drawing around your sample, which is really easy. So now we have these sketches. One important thing to remember is to click the letter T on your keyboard. That way, this outline that we've drawn is being added to the drawing manager. So that way, if by accident I click outside these drawn sketches, I can just go back to the drawing manager and I will have my sketches there and I don't have to be afraid. So because I want to draw these sketches on my bright field or my fluorescence image, because I don't want to show this bright field, all I have to do is click on my fluorescence image and click the outline. It will draw the exact same boundary that it has drawn on this bright on this mesh image onto my fluorescence channel. And now all we have to do is go to the plugin. Because I already installed the plugin for the dotted line, it will be in my quick tool for my plugin. If you haven't done this, all you have to do is to search the internet for ImageJ dotted line plugin. And it's really easy because once you just have, all you have to do is drag this stuff into your ImageJ. So you drag this guy into here and it will ask you to save it. So if you saved it, automatically you'll be able to find this in your plugin, just like I already do here. So I'm going to go ahead and select this dotted line plugin. By default, it will give you a line width of 5 and the space between the dash pattern about 12, which is okay for the standard. If you observe, my outline has been drawn in green. If you do not require a green outline, once this dotted line has been drawn, you can't undo it. If you click, oh, you can undo it by clicking Ctrl Z. So with that, you can then change the color of the outline that you prefer. So let's assume that we want a white outline. So you go to Image, Color Picker, and then you can choose white. So with that, we just go back to the plugin, select dotted line. Oh, you see, I've lost my outline. So I just click on this Drawing Manager to get back my outline. So now I have it. So what I did now was to click Ctrl E to paste that outline back on this image. Then we go to dotted line. We say okay, and you see we have a sketched outline as white. If you prefer to have your outline as a bigger width, for me this 5 is a good width of the outline. But if you prefer to have it as a bigger one, I'll be replicating this outline beside the same image to show you what happens if you increase your line width. Let us assume we increase our line width to 12. you will see that the thickness of the line width also it increased compared to what we have. And once you've done that, you could just save your image by you going to File, Save As, and if you save your image as JPEG, it's of good quality. So save it to your preferred file folder. And here we have a merged sample and the second one, which is the outline that we draw using the dotted line function. So if you have any question for me, please drop it in the comment section below. I'll be happy to take your questions. Thank you. And